That's what Mavi does. He has a lot of hard work and wicked. It's crazy. The nigga works hard, and I think that's why if you could put him in any art form, either video editing or anything, he will excel. Or even behind the radio mic, he will excel because he's a hard worker and an artist. So when it comes to his music and his coming project of music, I cannot wait to hear what he has for us. I really cannot, man. Can you imagine the music that is there? You know, knowing Mavi and how creative he is, how much of an artist he is, I can not wait to hear what his project is gonna sound like.
The next song is Riot, the Game Zulu. Yo, hey, yeah, it's Riot, and then in brackets, it's Indo Deum Zulu, which is Konulaga now, you know. That poem I'm just talking about is hey, Yazin. Nzulu's insane, I mean, yeah, more notes and been invading him because he's sat up and caught, you know. But there's levels to everything, and in that song, that's exactly what I'm talking about. I'm like, it's a trap song, but it has a very strong message, you know. I'm talking about Uti, Mina Ninengani, Zofiga, Ove, guys, Mnandi Lengo, right? And it's a trap track, you know. My influences for that one, I would have to say, with the beat. I kind of like there's a bit of like Travis Scott, you know, how I made the beat, and then the structure of the song, I would be like Sheck West. Loud. Anyways, like he was an influence. That's why you find me having like a very low tone voice on the song, you know. Yeah, come on, bass. I'm not, but. That's what I try to do, Lapana, and it sounds very nice. It's a track where I feel like Marsh Pits would open up for if I was to perform that in Bramfontein, Portland, or wherever the fun might be in a club situation. Yo! So, Rise with Yom Zulu. I think that's just about it. It's nothing much to it, but it's a very nice track, man. It sounds something like.
All my haters gon' whip out the voodoo. Must ain't push her into the balloon.